The pulp is the innermost part of the tooth containing nerves and blood vessels. And itis is a medical suffix denoting inflammation. Therefore, pulpitis is the inflammation of the dental pulp. How this develops is through bacterial infiltration, notably by pathogens such as Streptococcus mutans, Lactobacillus, and anaerobic species. This occurs through carious lesions or fractures within the teeth. The microbial invasion triggers an inflammatory cascade, resulting in a heightened pressure within the pulp chamber and the manifestation of pain or symptoms. Concurrently, the release of inflammatory mediators and immune responses contributes to progressive tissue damage. If this is left untreated, severe pulpitis can lead to necrosis, where the dental pulp undergoes irreversible damage and basically dies. Pulpitis stems from multiple causes. For example, dental caries, particularly when left untreated, provides a gateway for bacterial infiltration, leading to pulp inflammation. Additionally, factors such as recurrent caries underneath the restoration or a deep restoration contribute to ongoing decay and irritation to the pulp. Also, trauma or fractures in the teeth can expose the pulp, initiating the inflammatory response. Pulpitis manifests in two main types, reversible and irreversible pulpitis. With reversible, it usually occurs when the decay hasn't reached the pulp, affecting only the dentine, but the bacterial toxins cause the pulp to become irritated and reversibly inflamed. Meanwhile, irreversible pulpitis indicates infection extending into the pulp, signifying irreversible damage to the nerve of the tooth causing symptoms. You may differentiate the reversible and irreversible forms of pulpitis based on signs and symptoms as well as testing. Reversible pulpitis is characterized by temporary inflammation, often triggered by a stimulus, mostly cold but sometimes hot temperatures, causing sensitivity without irreversibly damaging the pulp. The sensitivity is temporary and does not linger. Now, irreversible pulpitis is extremely symptomatic and is characterized by severe, spontaneous pain that can be worse at nighttime or when lying down. Patients may experience heightened sensitivity to pressure and even lingering pain after the stimulus is removed. Sometimes, though, there are no symptoms, meaning the diagnosis has likely progressed from irreversible pulpitis into necrosis, where the tooth is basically dead. People at risk of pulpitis include those that have improper oral hygiene, those that infrequently visit the dentist for a checkup, and those that have a high sugar intake, and potentially those with a compromised immune system. Diagnosing pulpitis begins with a comprehensive dental exam, including the patient history and clinical evaluation. This is to inquire about the pain and its character, as well as to assess the tooth for decay and other factors that may contribute to the presentation. Additional testing can include pulp sensibility testing, as well as pulp sensitivity testing. Pulp sensibility, like CO2 tests or electronic pulp tests or EPTs, detect whether the pulp is necrotic or not. Basically, if there is a response, then the tooth is normal and not necrotic. Pulp sensitivity, on the other hand, includes the assessment of tooth sensitivity to temperature changes. In cold testing, a cold stimulus, basically a refrigerant spray or a cold test stick, is applied to the tooth to observe its response. While in warm testing, a warm gutta percha cone or a heated instrument is used. Sensitivity to heat and lingering pain to thermal testing generally leans more towards the diagnosis of irreversible pulpitis. A normal tooth will experience a quick, sharp pain that subsides immediately after removing the stimulus. No response to temperature changes may indicate a necrotic pulp. Dental imaging, such as a periapical radiograph, is crucial for detecting apical radiolucencies, offering insights into the extent of tooth decay and inflammation. For reversible pulpitis, for example, treatment focuses on addressing the decay through restorative treatments. In contrast, irreversible pulpitis may necessitate further intervention like root canal therapy, removing the infected pulp to preserve the tooth. Advanced cases may require tooth extraction as an alternative to root canal therapy, particularly when preservation is not feasible and a tooth is too far damaged. To summarize, pulpitis is an inflammation of the dental pulp caused primarily by bacterial infiltration through caries or fractures. Risk factors include poor oral hygiene and potentially compromised immunity. Pulpitis presents in two main forms, reversible and irreversible. Reversible pulpitis usually involves temporary inflammation triggered by stimuli like temperature changes with no irreversible damage to the pulp. In contrast, irreversible pulpitis signifies infection extending into the pulp, leading to irreversible damage and can manifest as symptomatic and potentially asymptomatic if there is necrosis. Diagnosis involves a comprehensive dental examination, pulp testing, as well as imaging. Management strategies vary with reversible pulpitis addressed through restorative treatments, while irreversible cases may require root canal treatment or extraction, depending on the factors and severity of tooth loss and decay.